Hello everyone, welcome to All Report. My name is Dinkar Purwar and I welcome you all in this session for ICR AO General Awareness section. Here we will be discussing some of the important question that has been asked earlier in the ICR AO examination. So the last time that ICR AO examination held in 2014 and in the General Awareness section and General Knowledge section, they have asked around 50 questions because that is a total number of questions they asked. So here we'll be discussing that 25 questions, and in the next week we'll be discussing another 25 questions. So by giving you this questions here, we'll be telling you like what kind of question ICR AO examination ask, and in what ways and in which direction you have to prepare for this examination. I hope everybody has already gone through the ICR AO notification and everything and preparation strategy that I have already been given. Okay, so now we'll be starting with our lecture, and we'll be discussing 25 important questions that has been asked earlier in the ICR AO examination. So let's start with our lecture now. So the first question for the last time that is they asked is, which of the following metal is the lightest metal? So may I know the answer of this question? If anybody knows about this, please write it in the comment box. Anybody knows which is the lightest metal? Please let me know. Mercury, sodium, potassium, lithium or beryllium. They can just tell me in the chat box. So be participative in the session. These questions have been asked earlier in the ICR AO examination. Okay, so anybody who knows the answer, they can just write in the chat box which one of the following metal is the lightest metal. I am waiting for the answer. Anybody, those who know the answer of this question, they can just write it in the comment box. I can see many people here in the chat box. They can just simply write it down. Okay, don't feel shy. It's just like we are learning over here, so don't feel shy, and it is just a preparation we are doing here. So Sire is saying is it's beryllium. Okay, anybody else who have a different answer regarding this question, they can also answer this question. Welcome Sire to the session. Okay, so the answer of this question is lithium. The answer of this question is lithium. Okay, lithium is the lightest metal of all. Okay, so the lightest or the least dense metal, that is the pure element, is the lithium, which has a density of 0.534 gram per centimeter cube. This makes the lithium nearly half dense as water. That means it is half dense than water. So if lithium was not so reactive, a chunk of metal would float on a water. Okay, so it is just like that. So here just an interesting fact related to the density. It is just it is an interesting fact. It is not related to any kind of this question. So here I am telling you, everybody knows the planet Saturn, right? Everybody knows the planet Saturn that is having the rings. Okay, Saturn is so light, that is, it is its density is so less. Like if we find a water bigger than water pool or an ocean bigger than a Saturn, then if we put the planet Saturn on that, it will float on the water. So the Saturn is so much Saturn planet density is so less that it would float on the water. Similarly here the lithium is there, so if lithium was not reactive that much, it will float on the water. So lithium is the lightest metal of all. Now question number two, RAC is viviparous, oviparous, ovviparous, octoparous, or none of the above. May I know the answer? Come on guys, be participative and keep answering the question. RAT is what type of orgasm? Viviparous, oviparous, ovviparous, octoparous, or none of the above. May I know the answer? Come on guys. So these questions have already been asked in the ICR AO general awareness section. Okay, so some are the general awareness and some are the static part. Okay, so these kind of questions have been earlier asked in the ICR AO examination. Please be participative. You can participate in the session. You can just select any of the option and I'll be telling you the answers. Okay, don't worry about the wrong answer. So may I know anybody who wanted to answer this question, they can easily answer this question. Okay, come on. So Isras is saying that is one, that is VV Paris. Okay, Isras, welcome to the session. Welcome to the session, and let's see the answer. The answer of this question is VV Paris. Okay, so what is this VV Paris organism are? So these are the mammals. Side is saying three. Okay, that's okay. So the answer is VV Paris. So the answer of this question is VV Paris. Okay, Side, I hope you got the answer. Okay, so who are the VV Paris organism? These are producing living youngs instead of eggs. So they are producing living young people. Earlier, some of the organism lays eggs. Some of the organism give birth to the living youngs. Okay, so producing living organism. They produce living youngs within the body in a manner that normally all the mammals do, many reptiles and few fishes do. Okay, so they are VV Paris. Now question number 3. Ligament join bone with bone, muscle, tendons, nerves, or none of the above. Ligaments join bones with what? Ligaments join bone with. So you can see that these are very basic general science question where very basic knowledge is required. So if you have read the NCERTs and all these things, and we have already prepared a detailed study material for you for ICREO examination, you can go to our Olive Board website and there you can register for the course. Okay, so Mayor, what are the ligaments? Ligaments join bone with what? Ligaments join bone with what? May I know the answer? Ligaments joins bones with what? Come on, participate, guys, participate. Santi Sarkar, welcome to the session. Santi, welcome to the session. So you are seeing three, that is tendons. Okay, ligaments join bones with what? Anybody else have different answers regarding this? They can also answer here. Anybody else who have a different answer regarding this, they can answer over here. Don't worry. Just don't worry about the answers and all. Just don't worry about it. Okay. You can just simply answer the question. Okay. Come on. So, Saire is saying two, that is muscles. Okay. But actually, the answer of this question is bones. Ligament join bone with bone. Okay, yeah, Aceres is right. Ligaments joins bones with bones. Okay, so now question number 4. What is question? Hello Geetanjali, welcome to the session, and your answer is also correct. Very good. Sudhir welcome to the session. So you are saying 3, that is tendon. So no, the answer is, hello Ribu, welcome to the session. Okay, thanks everybody. So telling your names and answering the questions, very good. At least participate in the session. Everybody will like the session. Okay, so ligaments join bone with bones. Okay, yeah, come on. So answer is bones. Okay, so now everybody was telling the next answer. Okay, golden rice helps in the elevating of DASH deficiency, vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin B12, or vitamin E. So, Geetanjali, Hemisaya, Sayanti, and Aceres all are telling it is vitamin A. Okay. Anybody else who wanted to answer this question? So, as you can see that these are the very basic question. These are the very basic question which are asked in the ICREO examination. And this year also, the basic question will be asked. Okay. This year also, yes, Ire, your answer is you are telling vitamin B12. Okay. So this year also they will be asking very basic question. You have to be very good in your fundamentals. If your fundamentals are good, then there is no need to fear about this examination. Just keep your fundamentals clear. Basic vitamins, minerals, metals. Okay, in the metals you don't have to remember all the metals. You have to remember the special metals, like which is the lightest metal, which is the metal which is liquid at room temperature, like that. You have to remember all these things. Okay, so only basic science knowledge and all these things are required. So the answer of this question is elevating of the vitamin A deficiency. Okay, fine. So golden rice is a GM crop, that is genetically modified crop intended to increase the dietary vitamin A. A serious health problem is in developing countries. Vitamin A deficiency can lead to the blindness and premature death. So rice, a food staple products of the garinogenol desulfate and early precursor of the beta carotene. Okay, so the answer is one, that is vitamin A. Okay, now question number 5. BT cotton has been produced by cloning of PRI1 AC gene, cloning of PRI2 AC gene, or cloning of BT gene, cloning of BTT gene, or cloning of B gene. May I know the answer? BT cotton has been produced. So BT cotton is a genetically modified crop, right? Everybody knows that, right? BT cotton is a genetically modified crop. So from which gene it has been produced? May I know the answer, guys? Please participate. Come on, start answering. BT cotton has been produced from which? So Thamisha is saying one, that is cloning of PRI1AC. Asaras is saying one. Okay. Anybody else who wanted to answer? Santi is saying one. Cloning of PRI1AC gene. Okay. Rebu is saying five. That is cloning of B gene. Doyle is saying four. Cloning of BTT gene. Oh my god. Thamisha M is saying, yeah, I got your answer, Thamisha. Okay, I got your answer. You have answered earlier. Okay. Fine. So BT cotton has been produced by which gene? Okay, so Dr. Shamisha Ayushi is saying three, that is cloning of BT genes. So I think Dr. Sharmin Idarsi is right over here. Okay, so she is right over here. So it is being produced by the cloning of the BT gene. Very good, good preparation, very good for this. Now, so insect resistant genetically modified cotton, it is also called BT cotton. Okay, was developed using a gene from the soil bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis, that is BT. So BT cotton enables the plant to produce the BT protein, which kills cotton major pests. So why this BT cotton has been made? Because it enables the plant to produce the BT protein, which kills cotton major pest Helotheus or the cotton blowworm, where it eats the leaves. So it kills the major pest of the cotton plant, so it protects the leaves of the cotton plant. Okay, now question number 6. Rain is called acid rain when its pH is below 6, 7, 7.5, 6.5 or 8. I think everybody should know this answer. Rain is called acidic rain when its pH is below 6, 7, 7.5, 6.5 or 8. So these are, what are the important, these are the very, very basic questions. These are the very, very basic questions they are asking in the ICRAO examination. If you have a fundamental knowledge about all these things, you can easily crack this examination. Very easily you can crack this examination. So rain, so Thamisha is saying 6.5. Rain is called acidic when its pH is below. Santi is saying 3, that is 7.5. Doyle is saying 2, that is 7. Anna is saying 4, that is 6.5. Okay. Dr. Sharmin Idarsi is saying 2, that is 7. Okay. Ribu is saying 6.5. Okay. Very good. Very good. Fine. Anybody else who wanted to answer this question? Anybody else who wanted to answer this question? Okay. So, see, I will just tell you the flow chart. Okay. So, the answer of this question is 7. Anything which is below 7 is acidic. Above 7 is called basic. Okay. So 7 is neutral. 7 is neutral. Okay. Neither acidic nor basic. Okay. 7 is neutral. But if anybody has a pH of above 7, that is called basic. And below 7, it is called acidic. Okay, so acid rain means they are coming acid. Acid is there in the rain. So it pH should be below 7. Okay, I hope everybody got the answer. Yeah, Ashia, yes, correct. You are also correct. Very good. So I hope everybody got the answer. So here you can see that pH is measured of how acid and base the thing is. The range goes from 0 to 14, where 7 being the neutral. pH of less than 7 is indicate acidity, whereas pH of greater than 7 indicate the base. Okay, so here you can see the flowchart. See, here this 7 is called neutral. 7 is neutral. See, basic and alkaline are both same thing. Yes, sir. Basic thing and alkaline things are same things. Okay, in the science. Okay. alkaline things have a pH of greater than 7. Okay, I hope you got the answer. Okay, so here if you see that 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, so all these things are basic. Till here, all these things are basic, and those who are below 7, these are called acidic. Acidic, and these are basic. These below things are acidic, and below 7 are acidic, and above 7 are basic. Okay, now question number 7. Effect of pollution is first marked on vegetation, water cycle, geochemical cycle, natural balance of environment, or all of the above. I hope Israf, you got the answer, because basic things and alkaline things are the same things. Okay, so effect of pollution is first marked on vegetation, water cycle, geochemical cycle, natural balance of environment, or all of the above. May I know the answer, guys? Come on, keep answering, guys. Come on. So Ribu has answered, that is fifth, that is all of the above. No, effect of the pollution is first marked. Matlab, on which thing we can see the effect of pollution in the starting stage. So Thamesha is saying fifth, Doyle is saying two, Dr. Shami is saying first one. Okay, so effect of pollution is first marked on which? Vegetation, water cycle. Ashish is saying D, that is natural balance of environment. Here the question is first, on which we can see the first effect of pollution. Okay, Santi is saying fifth, that is all of the above. See, so let's see the answer. The answer of this question is vegetation. In the starting phase, vegetation are affected more. Okay, in the starting phase. Later on, water cycle, geochemical cycle, nature balance of the environment, all will get affected. But in the first phase, vegetation will have a more impact. Okay, in the starting phase only, the vegetation will have the more impact. Okay, the answer is vegetation. Okay, the answer is vegetation. So in the later stage, water cycle, geochemical cycle, natural balance of the environment, but in the starting stage, the pollution will affect first the vegetation. Okay, I hope everybody got the answer right. Okay. Now question number 8. Process of flowering is influenced by air, water, nutrition, photoperiodism, or microbes. Process of flowering is influenced by air, water, nutrients, photoperiodism, or microbes. Process of flowering is influenced by what? Process of flowering is influenced by what? So Asuras is saying 4, that is photoperiodism. Okay, Anna is saying 4, that is photoperiodism. Santi is saying 1, Doyle is saying 3. Okay, anybody else who have any other or different answer regarding this? Process of flowering is influenced by what? So Dr. Sharman Idarsi is saying 4, that is photoperiodism. Okay, so anybody else? Ribu is saying 1, that is air. Mostly, matlab, in process of flowering is influenced by what? See, in the starting stage, okay, Sare is saying, Thamesima M is saying 4, that is photoperiodism. Sare is saying 4. So let's see the answer. The answer of this question is photoperiodism. The answer of this question is photoperiodism. Okay, answer is photoperiodism. Now, question number 9. Southernmost part of India, that is Kanyakumari, is south of equator, north of equator, parallel to equator, east of equator, or west of equator. Southernmost part of India, that is Kanyakumari, is south of equator, north of equator, parallel to equator, east of equator, or west of equator. Southernmost part of the India, that is Kanyakumari, is south of equator. So Anna is saying 2, that is north of equator. Okay, anybody else who wanted to answer this? Aesiris is saying two, north of equator. Okay. Doyle is saying three, that is parallel to equator. Dr. Sharmina Devdarshi is saying two. Aishi is saying three. Santi is saying three. Okay. Anybody else? Ribu is saying two, that is north of equator. Anybody else who wanted to answer this question? Okay, Sari is saying two, that is north of equator. Okay, so let's see the answer. The answer of this question is Kanyakumari is north of equator. So Kanyakumari is north of equator. Okay, first of all, you should know that there is no concept of east or west. There is no east or west. Okay, see, this is our globe, this is our equator. Okay, either something can be on the north or something can be on the south. There cannot be east or west in this equator. Okay, anything can be on south, anything can be on north, or anything can be on parallel with equator, right? So the answer is north of equator. So if you can see that, here is our country India. Okay, if you can see this equator, the line equator is going like this, this red line which I am drawing. Okay, so Kanyakumari is here. Okay, Kanyakumari is here. So it is north of equator. It is north of equator. Okay, and below this line is all things south of equator, right? And here you can see the Tropic of Cancer which passes through India. Okay, and here is Tropic of Capricorn, that is south of equator. So Tropic of Cancer is also above equator, that is north of equator, and Tropic of Capricorn is south of equator. I hope everybody got the answer properly, right? I hope everybody got it, right? Anybody has doubt, they can ask me right now regarding this. Okay, now we are moving forward. So question number 10. Quartzite is a metamorphosed form of greenstone, limestone, sandstone, ironstone, or gypsum. Quartzite is metamorphosed form of what? Greenstone, limestone, sandstone, ironstone, or gypsum. May I know the answer, guys? Quartzite is metamorphosed form of what? So, please answer, guys. Okay, Themissa is saying 3. That is sandstone. Okay. Anybody else who have answers? Aisha is saying 5, that is gypsum. Okay. See, first of all, you see all these questions are such a basic question and very important. See, this is a very basic geography question. Very basic geography question. Type of rocks. Okay. Doyle, Santi, Aesiris is saying sandstone, Dr. Shamina is saying 2, that is limestone. Okay, so these are very, very basic question. These are like important rocks of the world. Okay, I hope everybody got it, right? So Sarve is saying 5th, that is gypsum. Okay, so you can just imagine what kind of question can be asked. See, very basic question are asked in the ICAR AO examination. So these are the question that they have asked in 2014. Okay, I hope everybody got it, right? So the answer is sandstone. The answer is sandstone. The answer is sandstone. Okay. Now, question. So quartzite is a metamorphosed form of the sandstone. So quartzite is a non-foliate metamorphic rock composed almost entirely of the quartz. It forms when the quartz-rich sandstone is altered by the heat, pressure, and the chemical activity. So what is the process of metamorphism? What is metamorphism? It is like altering of any of the composition of the structure of a rock by heat, pressure, or other natural agency. Okay. So when sandstone is worked by heat, pressure, or natural agencies, it converts into the quartzite. Okay. Now, question number 11. Name the strait where Adam Bridge is situated. Park Strait, 10 degree channel, 9 degree channel, Strait of Malacca, Duncan Passage. Name the strait where Adam Bridge is situated. Park Strait, 10 degree channel, 9 degree channel, Strait of Malacca, or Duncan Passage. May I know the answer, guys? name of the street where Adams Bridge is situated. Come on, fast enough, guys. Come on, start. So you are saying one, that is Park Street, Isras. Okay. Start answering, guys. Come on, be fast enough. Santi is saying one. Okay. Sare is saying five. That is Duncan Passage. Okay. Dr. Shami Aidarsi is saying one. That is Park Street. Okay. So till now, most of the people have answered it correctly. And Arsh is saying four. That is State of Malacca. First of all, you should know what is Adams Bridge. Anybody knows what is Adams Bridge? Ina is saying one. That is Park Street. What is the other name of the Adams Bridge? Anybody knows what is the other name of Adams Bridge? Okay. Anybody who knows the other name of the Adams Bridge? There is a different name also for the Adams Bridge. It is an English name, but there is also a Hindi name for that. Okay. So let's see the answer. The answer is Park Street. So Adams Bridge is situated in Park Street. Okay. Yes. It is called Rama Setu. Yes, it is called Rama Setu. Yes, Asaras was right. Very good. Knowledge you have. Very good. And even most of the people are having good knowledge over here, and they are answering the question. Yes. Chandrasekhar is saying Park Street. Yes, I got your answer, and welcome to the session, Chandrasekhar. Okay. Now, so the Adams Bridge is situated in Park Street. So if you can see here, this is Park Street. Okay. This is our Adams Bridge, which is connecting our India, Ramathapuram, with the Sri Lanka. Okay. Yeah. Shamina Hidarthi, it is called Rama Setu. Yes. No, it has been given by the earlier British people at that time. Okay. It has been given earlier by the people, those who have found it out. Okay. Okay. So this is the Adams Bridge. So it is connecting the part of India with the Sri Lanka. Okay. Fine. Everybody got it? Yeah. The answer is, it is Rama Setu. Yeah. Okay. Now, so question number 12, the Gayatri Mantra contained in the Rig Veda is dedicated to which deity? Lakshmi, Saraswati, Parvati, Durga, or Savitri? Yes, very good. So the Gayatri Mantra contained in the Rig Veda is dedicated to which deity? Lakshmi, Saraswati, Parvati, Durga, or Savitri? Okay, come on, start answering. The Gayatri Mantra contained in the Rig Veda is dedicated to which deity? So these are all the questions, the basic question that has been asked earlier in the ICAR AO examination. Okay, so Sare is saying 2, that is Saraswati, and Ribu is saying that is Lakshmi. Okay, Thamesa is saying Savitri. Okay, Doyle is saying 3, that is Parvati. Then Asaras is saying 5, that is Savitri. Okay, Santi is saying 3, that is Parvati. Anybody else who have any different kind of answer regarding this, they can answer. Chandrasekhar is saying it is Lakshmi. Okay. I have got little bit of cold today. Sorry for this interruption. So Dr. Shamina is saying a fifth one, that is Savitri. Okay. So let's see the answer of this question. First of all, let's see the answer of this question. So I hope everybody might be knowing the Gayatri Mantra. Okay. So the answer is Savitri. Okay, the answer is Savitri. Okay, so the Gayatri Mantra contained in the Rig Veda is dedicated to the Savitri goddess. Okay, so the Gayatri Mantra, also known as Savitri Mantra, is a highly revered mantra for the Rig Veda dedicated to the Vedic deity of Savitri. So it is Om Bhurva Swaha Tat Savitur Varendyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yona Prachodayat. Okay, this is Gayatri Mantra, and it is dedicated to Savitri goddess. Okay. I hope everybody got the answer for that, right? Now, question number 13. India's Green Revolution started from which city? Pantnagar, Roorkee, Haldwani, Kashipur, Almora. Everybody knows that Green Revolution is a very big revolution that has been taken place in India. Okay? In the 1950s and 60s phase. So, you should also know that from which city it started. Whether it started from Pantnagar, Roorkee, Haldwani, Kashipur, or Almora. May I know the answer, guys? Indian Green Revolution started from where? Come on, come on, come on, fast, 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 fast. So, Sare Singh won, that is Pantanagar. Okay. So, Chandrasekhar, thanks. Thank you so much, Chandrasekhar. Thank you so much. We are especially doing this for ICERAO aspirants because those filled a form. I know the content is not available and we are doing this series because everybody will be looking for the previous year question paper. But after 2014, this exam is happening in 2021. Okay. So that is why we have prepared two series for this. So this week we are taking 25 questions and the next week we'll be taking 25 questions. Thank you so much for the comment, Chandrasekhar. So, Lata is saying Pantanagar, Doyal is saying Pantanagar, Dr. Shamina is saying Pantanagar, Santi is saying Pantanagar, okay? And Pantanagar is also famous for one university. Pantanagar is also famous for one university, right? Aisha is saying one, that is Agriculture University, okay? It is also famous for Agriculture University. So, the answer of this question is Pantanagar. Okay, the answer is Pantanagar. Okay, now the Green Revolution was a period where agriculture in India was converted into an industrial system due to the adoption of the modern method of technologies. Then we have used high yielding variety of seeds, we have used tractors, irrigation facilities, pesticides and fertilizer. So it was mainly led by our agriculture scientist, that is M.S. Swaminathan. Everybody has known the name of M.S. Swaminathan. Okay, he is the big name in the Indian agriculture field because he is the harbinger of the Green Revolution, okay, in India. So this period was a part of large Green Revolution that has been taken throughout the world, and the Nobel laureate Dr. Norman E. Borlaug, which leveraged the agriculture research and technology to increase agriculture production in the developing countries. So under the premiership of the Congress leader, that is Lal Bahadur Shastri ji, the Green Revolution which within India commenced in 1965, leading to the increase in the food grain production, especially in Punjab, Haryana and northern Uttar Pradesh, or we can say it's western Uttar Pradesh. Major milestone in this undertaking were the development of the high yielding variety of wheat and the rust resistant strain of the wheat. So this is about the Green Revolution. Yes, Ari, you are right. This is an agriculture university, Pantanagar Agriculture University. Okay, fine. Now question number 14. This is very easy. You should also focus on all the reports that has been published by the various world organization. Global competitiveness report is related to which of the following organization? World Bank, IMF, World Economic Forum, ADB or AIIB? So may I know the answer, guys? Global competitiveness report is related to which of the following organization? World Bank, IMF, World Economic Forum, ADB or AIIB? So you should know the reports related to ADB, World Bank, IMF, World Economic Forum, okay, and various other organization. Very important reports are there. So Chandrasekhar is saying 2, that is IMF. Ribu is saying 3, that is World Economic Forum. Okay, Santi is saying 3, that is World Economic Forum. Dr. Shrimini is saying that is 3, World Economic Forum. Okay, Aswaras is saying 3, that is World Economic Forum. Okay, global. So you should know about the important report published by various world organization. Okay, everybody should focus on all these reports. You don't have to go inside the report. Okay, they will not ask you data about that. But you should know that which report is published by which organization. Okay, very important topics regarding this. I hope everybody got it. So the answer of this question is World Economic Forum. That is WEF. Okay, World Economic Forum. Now, question number 15. Octroi is levied and collected by. Also, octroi is a type of tax. Okay, octroi tax is levied and collected by central government, state government, local bodies, or both one and two. May I know the answer? Your answer was also right. Previous one. Okay, octroi tax is levied and collected by who? May I know the answer, guys? Octroi is levied and collected by central government, state government, local bodies, or both one and two. Come on. Octroi tax was there. Okay. So Ribu is saying 4, that is both one and two. Okay. May I know other people? Come on. Answer, guys. ओके कम ऑन फास्ट एनफ गाइस फास्ट 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 सारे सिंक थ्री दैट इज लोकल बॉडीज ओके ओके ऑक्ट्रॉय इज लिवाइड एंड कलेक्टेड बाय हु सो द आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑक्ट्रॉय टैक्स इज लिवाइड बाय द लोकल बॉडीज या आंसर इज द थर्ड वन दैट इज ऑक्ट्रॉय टैक्स इज लिवाइड बाय द लोकल बॉडीज ओके सो इट इज लिवाइड बाय द लोकल बॉडीज ओके ऑक्ट्रॉय टैक्स इज लिवाइड बाय द लोकल बॉडीज ओके यस यस योर नो डॉक्टर समीना योर आंसर इट इज लिवाइड बाय द लोकल बॉडीज आई होप प्लीज गेट योर आंसर करेक्टेड ओके सो octroi is charged at a point of the entry of goods in a local area of consumption that means octroi is a type of tax where if a good is entering in any of the other state like this is one place and this is other place so if the good is coming from here to here so here one checkpoint is there you have to pay octroi tax okay in order to move in order to move your product inside this place okay you have to pay the octroi tax okay So, it is an account-based levy collected by the Sales Tax Administration. But when the GST came, you know GST came on 1st July 2017? Everybody knows. No, it is not present. No, now ASRAS, it is not present under GST. I have already mentioned here. As of July 1st, 2017, when the GST came, the octroi has been abolished. Okay? The octroi tax has been abolished. Okay? Because when this last examination happened in 2014, at that time, The octroi tax was there. Okay, that is why this question was here. Okay, now the octroi tax is not there. It has been abolished with the introduction of the GST. Okay, I hope you got your answer, right? Now, question number 16. When was the first session of the Lok Sabha held? 13 May 1952, 14 May 1952, 15 May 1952, 16 May 1952, 11th May 1952. When was the first session of the Lok Sabha was held? When was the first session of the Lok Sabha held? Come on. When was the first session of Lok Sabha held? Don't write the full answer, just write the option number. Okay? If anybody knows this, they can just write the option numbers. Okay? Ribu is saying 1, that is 13 May. Okay? Anybody else? Asuras is 1. Okay, fine. Anybody else who wanted to answer this question? Devesh. Hello, Devesh. Welcome to the session. You are saying 3rd. That is 15th May. Chandrasekhar is saying 13 May 1952. Doyle is saying 14th May. Okay, see, I have kept the options very close by in order to confuse you guys. Because so that... In the exam, you don't get confused. That is why I always keep the options very close so that you should know the exact dates, exact numbers, exact figures. Okay. That is why I always keep the options very close by. So, Doyle is saying 2, that is 14 May. Dr. Shamir is saying 3, that is 15th May. So, let's see the answer. The answer of this question is 13 May 1952. So, the first session of the Lok Sabha was held in Yes, Anti Sarkar. Yes, yes. So, the first session of Lok Sabha held in 13 May 1952. Okay, now question number 17. Holocaust Remembrance Day observed on January 27, 2014 referred to an event of which of the following wars? First World War, Second World War, Vietnam War, Cold Wars. Holocaust Remembrance Day observed on January 27, 2014. So see, the last paper happened in 2014. So that is why they have taken question from there. But it is the Holocaust Remembrance Day. Every year it is remembered. Okay, so anybody knows the answer? Holocaust Remembrance. So first of all, you should know what is the meaning of Holocaust. Anybody know what is the meaning of Holocaust? So Devesh is saying Second World War. Okay, Holocaust Remembrance Day refers to an event of which of the following wars? Yes, so Devesh is saying Second World War. Okay, Dr. Shamir is saying Second World War. Shanti is saying A Second World War. Emma is saying Second World War. Okay. Okay. So let's see the answer. The answer of this question is Second World War. Because it is because of the Hitler. Hitler and Jews. हिटलर वॉन्टेड टू किल द ज्यूस पीपल. ओके, हिटलर वॉन्टेड टू किल द ज्यूस पीपल. नो प्रॉब्लम चंद्रशेखर, जस्ट वी आर जस्ट रिवाइजिंग ओवर. ओके, डोंट वरी अबाउट इट. सो वी आर जस्ट रिवाइजिंग दिस थिंग. सो हिटलर फॉर द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर, या इट इज अ डिस्ट्रक्शन. यस स्वामीना, यस यस, वेरी गुड, थैंक यू सो मच. या सो द होलोकॉस्ट ऑल्सो नोन एज सोहा इन द हिब्रू लैंग्वेज, विच इज स्पोकन बाय द ज्यूस पीपल. इट वॉज अ जीनोसाइड ऑफ द यूरोपियन ज्यूस ड्यूरिंग द वर्ल्ड वॉर ऑफ टू. Between 1941 and 1945, Nazi Germany and its collaborator have systematically murdered around 6 million Jews people across the German occupied Europe. Around 2/3 of the Jews population has been murdered. So the murder was carried out in a program and mass shooting by a policy of extermination through a labor. Concentration camps were there. They will be kept in a very concentration camp. There the gas they will release, the poisonous gas they will release. Okay. So as early in 1919, Adolf Hitler was there. He has written Rational Anti-Semitism. However, he has led to a systematic legal opposition and in final objective may unleashing the removal of Jews. So Hitler wanted to remove all the Jews because he thought that Jews people wanted to struggle and wanted to control the world. That is why Hitler wanted to remove all the Jews, because Hitler thought that Jews people were in an evil race struggling for the world domination. That is why Hitler wanted to remove all the Jews people. Okay, and you should also know that Hitler has wrote a book that is called Mein Kampf. Okay, just 1 minute, I will just show you the book. I am having that book, just 1 minute. If guys can see this book, so this is the book Hitler has wrote. Just 1 minute. I hope everybody can see. So this is the book that Hitler has wrote, Mein Kampf. Okay. So this is the book that has been wrote by Hitler. Okay, fine. So now. Question number 18. Which of the following is a non-metal that remains liquid at room temperature? Which of the following is a non-metal that remains liquid at room temperature? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine or silicon? Which of the following is a non-metal that remains liquid at room temperature? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine or silicon? Okay, great. I hope everybody has seen the book. So tell me, which of the following is a non-metal that remains liquid at room temperature? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine or silicon? So Anna is saying three, that is bromine. Okay, Rebu, Devesh, Lata, okay, all are saying bromine. Okay, anybody else? Shanti is saying bromine. Okay, everybody is saying bromine. That is, bromine is a non-metal that remains liquid at room temperature. Okay, let's see the answer. The answer of this question is bromine. The answer of this question is bromine. Okay, so this is that. Bromine is the only non-metallic element that is liquid at ordinary temperature. It is dense, reddish brown liquid, which evaporates very easily at the room temperature to a red vapors with a strong chlorine like odor. Okay, so bromine is less reactive than chlorine. So bromine is used in many areas such as agriculture, chemical, dye stuff, insecticides, pharmaceutical and chemical intermediaries. So some use are being phased out because of the environmental reason, but new uses continues to be found. So okay, so bromine compound are also used in the flame retardant, so they reduce the flames. Yes, Dr. Shamina, your answer is also correct. So this is bromine. It looks a reddish brown color. Okay, this is bromine. Okay, now question number 19. What percentage of land area should remain under forest cover to maintain ecological balance? 11%, 22%, 33%, 31% or 21%? What percentage of the land area should remain under the forest cover to maintain the ecological balance? 11%, 22%, 33%, 31% or 21%? So, may I know the answer, guys? Come on, answer fast enough, fast guys. So Ribu is saying fifth, that is 21%. Okay, Devesh is saying 33, Anna is saying 33, Dr. Simon is saying 33, and it's saying 33. Okay, anybody else who wanted to answer? Lata is saying 33, Santi is saying 33%. Okay, so what percentage of the land should area should cover under forest to maintain the ecological balance? So the answer of this question is 33%. So we need to cover our land area of 33% by the forest cover. Okay, fine. Now question number 20, full form of BOD. What is the full form of BOD? Anybody knows what is the full form of BOD? They can write in the chat box immediately, fast. What is the full form of BOD? What is the full form of BOD? Santis, correct. So what is the full form of BOD? What is the full form of BOD? Write fast. Come on, write it fast. Come on, guys, write it fast. What is the full form of BOD? What is the full form of BOD? BOD. Come on, guys. Come on. Don't know. Biological oxygen demand. Okay, Santi saying biological. Yes, Ripu, biological oxygen demand. Okay, very good, guys. Yes, very good. I think the answer is a little bit long, so that is why people are taking a long time to answer. Hello, Arpan. Welcome to the session. And Dr. Samina is saying biological. Okay, Ripu is saying yes. All are correct over here. So BOD represent. Yes, Ripu, yes. Everybody is right here. Biological oxygen demand. Biological oxygen demand. Anybody knows what is the advantage of this biological oxygen demand? So I will be letting you know. So biological oxygen demand represent the amount of oxygen that is consumed by the bacteria while they decompose the organic matter under the aerobic conditions. Okay, so it is the amount of I am telling you. So biological oxygen demand is the amount of oxygen that is being used by the organism that are present in the water bodies or any of the places to decompose the organic matter. Okay, so the presence of sufficient concentration of the dissolved oxygen is critical to maintain the aquatic life and aesthetic quality of the stream and the lakes. So how organic matter affects the concentration of the dissolved oxygen? So BOD is a measure of the amount of oxygen that is required to remove the waste organic matter. Okay, yeah, it is consumed by the microorganism, okay, or the fish or anything. Okay, yeah, so biological oxygen demand is measure of the amount of oxygen required to remove the waste organic material from the water, because these are the microorganism, they live on the oxygen and they decompose the organic matter. Okay, so that means if a water or a place is having a low BOD, that means low BOD means there are less pollution means they have a low biological oxygen demand. That means there will be less organism because they will not be required to decompose anything. Yes, it is accessing for the water quality. Low BOD means less pollution, while high BOD indicates the pollution in the water is high. That means there will be more microorganism that will be required to remove that organic matter from the water or anything. Okay, so low BOD means less organism, less organic pollutants. Okay, so you should know that BOD is an indicator of the low BOD. Low BOD, good quality of water. High BOD, polluted water. Okay, low BOD, good quality water. High BOD, polluted water. Right, I hope everybody got the answer right. Fine. Now, question number 21. By which name cellular and molecular control of programmed cell death is known as? By which name cellular and molecular control of programmed cell death is known as? So, By which name cellular and molecular control of programmed cell death is known as degeneration, aging of cell, necrosis, apoptosis? So Arpan is saying fourth one, that is apoptosis. Okay. By which name cellular and molecular control of programmed cell death is known as what? May I know the answer, guys? By which name cellular and molecular control programmed death cell is known as? Devesh is saying skip. Dr. Sharman is saying fourth one. Okay. So Dr. Sharman is saying right answer. So congrats to them. Okay. You are always saying the right answers. Okay. So Santi is saying four. That is apoptosis. Okay. Fine. So let's see the answer. The answer of this question is apoptosis. Okay. So it is also called as molecular, cellular and molecular control of programmed cell death. Okay. Now, so a type of cell death in which a series of molecular steps can lead to its death. This is one method by the body used to get rid of the unneeded abnormal cells. The process of apoptosis may be blocked in a cancer cell, also called programmed cell death. That means those people who are having cancer, in that this process of apoptosis was came down. The process of apoptosis is blocked in the people who are having cancer, so that the body cannot get rid of the unneeded abnormal cells, and these abnormal cells can grow in the body. But those in the body where the apoptosis is working properly, so there are no cancerous cells that are present. Okay. Now, question number 22. Economic justice as one of the Indian constitution has been provided in preamble, fundamental rights, directive principle of state policies, or the preamble and the directive principle of the state policies. So economic justice is provided where? Economic justice is provided where? Preamble, fundamental rights, directive principle of state policies, the preamble and the directive principle of state policy. Where? Economic justice. Where is economic justice is provided? Where it is written about the economic justice? May I know? So Arpan is saying one, that is preamble. Devesh is saying fourth one, that is the both one. Okay. Anybody else who have different answer? May I know? Just and Pawan, one. Okay. Sarah is saying fourth one. Okay. May I know the answer? Okay. Yes. Most of the questions are science related. As you know that the ICAR, Indian Council of Agriculture Research, it is a scientific organization, right? It is a scientific organization. They are mostly focusing on the science question. So, but they are not totally asking the science question. They are asking current affairs, science, biology, physics. Then they are also asking about your polity, economy, social justice, and everything they are asking. Okay. So it is, but mostly most of the questions are science based, but it is a balanced paper. Okay. So Chandrasekhar is saying three, that is directive principles. Dr. Samir is saying fourth one. Okay. Santi is saying fourth one. So let's see the answer. The answer of this question is fourth one. Okay. So the preamble and the directive principle of the state policies. Okay. It is present in the both. The economic justice present in the preamble also, and it is also present in the directive principle of the state policy. Okay. Now question number 23. In India, deficit planning is used for raising resource for what? Social development, economic development, environmental development, or political development? In India, deficit planning is used to raise resources for what? In India, deficit planning is used for raising resources for social development, economic development, environmental development, or political development. May you know the answer? Yeah, Devesh is saying one, that is social development. Okay, Sari is saying two, that is economic development. Okay, anybody else who wanted to answer this question? Anybody else who wanted to answer this question? In India, deficit planning is used for raising resource for what? So this is related to economy, Indian economy, right? Lataji is saying two, that is economic development. Sandy is saying B. Chandrasekhar is saying B. Okay, so let's see the answer of this question. The answer of this question is economic development. So, okay, deficit planning is used for the economic development. Okay, yeah. Correct, Dr. Sherman. Okay, very correct. Okay, the answer is deficit economic development. Okay, now question number 24. What does an antigen do? stop the formation of antibody, stimulate formation of antibody, slow down formation of antibody, or stimulate formation of antigens? Yes, Joey. Yes, yes, correct. So what does an antigen do? Stops the formation of antibody, stimulates formation of antibody, slow down the formation of antibody, or stimulates the formation of antigen. This is the second last question, and I just request you, everybody should give the feedback regarding this session. Please guys, it is very important for us, so that please let us know how you like the session, so that we can come more sessions like this. Okay, so Devesh is saying too, that is stimulates the formation of antibodies. Okay, so I would be just requesting everybody to please provide the feedback regarding this session. Okay, I hope you are liking the session. Please let us know in the feedback section here, or just write in the comment box or in the chat box, wherever you want. Okay, so Lata, Devesh, Chandrasekhar, all are saying stimulates formation of antibody. Okay, so let's see the answer. The answer of this question is, it stimulates the formation of antibody. Okay, it stimulates the formation of antibody. Okay, yes, 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 Dr. Shumina, it's correct. Okay, now last question for today is, hybridization is, what is hybridization? Okay, yes, Auntie, you are also right. Hybridization is self-fertilization, cross-fertilization between two varieties, or oviparity or viviparity. What is hybridization? What is hybridization? Hybridization is self-fertilization, cross-fertilization, oviparity or viviparity. Please give all the reviews regarding this session in the comment box, chat box, guys, so that we can come with more session like this. So what is hybridization? So Lata is saying cross fertilization, Doyle is saying 2. Okay, anybody else who wanted to answer this? Santi is saying B, that is cross fertilization. Chandrasekhar is saying 2, Shaman is saying 2. Okay, let's see the answer of this question. The answer of this question is, it is the cross fertilization between the two varieties. Okay, so I hope these 25 questions that has been asked earlier in the ICRAO examination, you have gone through this. Okay, so next week also, again on Wednesday at 7 PM, we'll be coming with again next 25 question that has been asked. So be prepared for this session, and please be there for the session so that you can understand what kind of question these people were asking, so that you can prepare on that basis. Okay. Please give a review about this in the comment box or chat box, and do like the session. And at the last, we will ask you, never forget to like, subscribe and follow. Happy learning, guys. Thank you so much, guys. I hope all of you have liked the session, and I hope you have got a learning also from here. And do let us know about the reviews from your side. And till then, never forget to like, subscribe and follow. Happy learning. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye.